Beyond Meat stocks have tripled since May. And in a way, we have a repeat of what was going on about 50 years ago. When the USDA dietary guidelines, essentially the food pyramid, was created in the late 1970s, our way of eating shifted to a heavily grain-based and processed foods diet, all to line the pockets of large food companies, big agriculture, big business. The difference here is that word got out about dangerous chemicals being used to make these plant crap patties. This burger, this meat, contains vegetable oils, and all vegetable oils require hexane to be made. Hexane is a solvent chemical made from crude oil. Short-term exposure to hexane causes dizziness, nausea, headaches, and even unconsciousness. It damages your nervous system, and we're using it to make our food. I've tried these plant-based patties for experimental purposes. If you smell them, it smells like a chemical that came out of a laboratory. If you taste it when it's not cooked, it tastes like poison from a laboratory. And if you cook it and add salt and pepper to it, that actually changes the flavor to something that is more reminiscent of meat. It's completely horrible that we are being poisoned by these food companies and they are still getting away with it. Vegetable oils are literally the worst thing you can consume. When you consume vegetable oils, all of the fats, all of the lipids in your body, the cholesterol particles start becoming composed of vegetable oil, linoleic acid. When your fat cells become composed of linoleic acid, they can oxidize, lead to heart disease. It's literally the cause of heart disease and it's being peddled as healthy. Take a look at the ingredients in Beyond Meat. We have pea protein isolate. Unfortunately, pea protein contains anti-nutrients, lectins, and phytates. These can cause leaky gut and inhibit nutrient absorption. It has vegetable oils, perfect for clogging our arteries, canola oil. Then we have a bunch of laboratory ingredients, from starches to sugars, fillers, and flavorings. This is arguably the unhealthiest thing you can put in your body. Omega-6 fats, carbohydrates is the most inflammatory combination you can create. Add a little bit of sugar to that, and then you have a real nightmare. This food is clearly poison, yet we have nutritionists saying it's a healthy option. One nutritionist said, "I don't love that the patties are made with coconut oil. This is a source of saturated fat, and you'll see that one burger contains 30% of the recommended daily value. Because coconut oil contains more saturated fat than butter or lard, many nutritionists recommend using it sparingly." It's crazy how these people demonize saturated fat, yet they're ignoring how dangerous vegetable oils and these chemicals are to our health. But compared to lots of other highly processed foods, Bonnie said, the Beyond Burger uses particularly high-quality ingredients like mung bean protein, apple extract, and pomegranate fruit powder. When it comes to choosing between a Beyond Burger and a real meat patty, the nutritionists agree that the vegan burger was the healthiest choice. I do believe that plant options that displace red meat are a step in the right direction, said Seth, who added, red meat is tied to some of our most prevalent chronic diseases. The protein has been associated with type 2 diabetes and heart disease, and processed meats like sausage, bacon, and hot dogs could increase the risk of stomach and bowel cancers.
Red meat also plays a role in climate change, which SAS calls a major public health risk. the World Health Resources Institute estimates that cutting the world's beef consumption by 70% could reduce greenhouse gas emissions by around 35%.
The truth is that the protein source we consume does matter, both for human health and the health of the planet.
I know the voices are a little ridiculous, but everything that's coming out of their mouth is a ridiculous lie, so I gotta put on my clown shoes for a few minutes, also just to tolerate this nonsense. I can't stand how the media gets away with pushing lies every single day. On Wednesday, I spoke about how Hong Kong has the highest meat consumption, yet the highest life expectancy. I bet you never see that in the news. And how exactly would cutting the world's beef consumption by 70% reduce greenhouse gas emissions by around 35% if the emissions for all agriculture only totals to 9%? Dietitians just make up numbers and pull lies out of their ass, hoping people appeal to the authority of the word dietitian, their
credentials.
These dietitians and nutritionists will be looked upon in the future as brainwashed robots who fell into the trap of modern conventional wisdom. Or maybe not. Maybe all of our brains will be fried from EMF and degenerated from all of the crap we're consuming. I came across another news piece on The Guardian demonizing meat, suggesting plant-based alternatives, which is simply an opinion piece written by some brainwashed vegan writing for The Guardian.
Meat is dead. Carnivores are going the way of cigarette smokers, and by 2050, there's a good chance that it will be socially unacceptable to eat meat. In the same way that we're horrified people used to smoke in offices and airplanes, we'll find it almost unthinkable that people used to consume animals so casually and frequently.
If you tell a lie enough times, it becomes the truth. These people need to be stopped and put into an insane asylum. What's hilarious is these vegans are actually just making stuff up completely. In this article, they said the reason humans started eating meat is because droughts made fruits and vegetables less abundant. What were the animals eating if fruits and vegetables were less abundant? I should start saying that eating steak every day made me 7 feet tall and my PP grew 10 inches. And I mean, that would be essentially the same credibility of what a vegan is saying. There was even a video last week with Dr. Mike, a very popular YouTuber, trying out plant-based burgers and saying that some specific ones were good, some were bad. It's very clear that Beyond Meat and Impossible Foods have a lot of money and influence. There are too many news articles recently to count, but this one was pushing this as well. The shift towards flexitarian, vegetarian, and vegan lifestyles is undeniable, with many consumers cutting down on their meat consumption as a result of becoming more conscious towards the environment and animal welfare, said Carson Gerhardt, a partner at A.T. Kearney. For passionate meat eaters, the predicted rise of cultured meat products means that they still get to enjoy the same diet they always have, but without the same environmental and animal costs attached. Tyson and Cargill, two major food companies, are jumping on this plant-based bullshit meat bagging as well. It's upsetting how easily the population is manipulated and led to believe the opposite of what is true. We are convinced meat is bad for you, bad for the environment, but eat this plant-based crap from a company that was selling you tortured chickens 5 years ago? And, you know, the hypocrisy here is unreal. The solution here is to support quality food. Grass-fed beef is actually good for the environment because of the carbon that gets stored in the soil. You'll never hear this in the news. They don't want you to be healthy. They don't want to sell grass-fed beef. They're not going to make money off of grass-fed beef. They're set up to sell you thousands and thousands and millions of pounds of conventionally raised crappy meat full of vegetable oil, soy. They feed the animals plastic. They make money selling you crap. They don't make money selling you good food. We know that, and people don't see it. So thank you guys for joining me today. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon, and share it if you can. Recently, I've launched Frankie's Free Range Meat, providing you guys with the highest quality, most nutrient-dense animal foods at an affordable price. Go to frankiesfreerangemeat.com if you want to look like a Roman statue on the inside and out. And if you want to look like you are cast out of bronze, go to frankiesnaturals.com. We offer minimally processed, minimal ingredient hygiene and cosmetic products such as aluminum-free deodorant, fluoride-free tooth powder, vitamin D3 moisturizing cream, aka Frankie's ball grease. Again, thank you guys for joining me and enjoy the rest of your week.